Chief financial officers, corporate treasurers, bankers, insurers and consultants were all gathered at the headquarters of the Dubai Chamber on Monday the 24th of June for the regional launch of the Uniform Rules for Bank Payment Obligation by the ICC's Regional Banking Commission for the Middle East and North Africa. Opening speakers at the launch ceremony included senior members of the Dubai Chamber as well as the International Chamber of Commerce's Regional Banking Commission.
Today it's quite an important day for ICC and for Dubai Chamber because we'll be releasing two major documents publication. One is the bank payment obligation rules, and we do the release on a regional basis here with Dubai Chamber, our partner. And the second product is quite important as well, is the ICC Global Trade Finance Survey 2013, which is a flagship publication for ICC Banking Commission in the sense that it gives an overview of trends and opportunities for trade finance worldwide with some very good regional trends as well. So it was making plenty of sense to do it on a regional basis here with Dubai Chamber.
A panel discussion followed and included a Q&A session with senior representatives from Swift Middle East, JP Morgan, Standard Chartered Bank, and the Commercial Bank of Dubai, giving the corporate perspective and relevance of the new rules and how these will impact businesses in the MENA region.
Well, today we had two very important components to this event. And the first one just concluded with great interest from the participants here was the launch of the Uniform Rules for the Bank Payment Obligation. These are new rules facilitating international trade and finance. So kind of in simple terms, it's a set of rules in respect of banks' obligations to pay against electronic, you could say, presentation of documents. So letters of credit, traditionally, a very valuable product, very useful in trade, but with a lot of inefficiencies for regular exporters and importers. These new rules will facilitate trade for these ongoing clients, and indeed in facilitating trade will make trade more secure and increase the availability of trade finance.
The closing part of the morning session was dedicated to the announcement of the key findings of the ICC's Global Trade Finance Survey for 2013, a survey which provides a detailed statistical analysis of the regional and global trends in trade finance.
So every year since the financial crisis, we do a survey around the world with banks to determine what are the key issues facing them and their clients in terms of international trade. So we have just concluded our survey, and actually today will be the global launch of the survey here in Dubai.
We've been using traditional instruments like letters of credit and open account trading. So this seemed to be a very new concept, which is like bridging the gap between a letter of credit and an open account transaction. So basically wanted to know like how the, and this being a new product, a new set of rules being launched, wanted to know how this could practically be applicable to our clients, whether we could go forward, the cost involved, and how this our clients could benefit from this new product and service. And definitely it's been very informative.